I was at something similar to this, and I had the audacity to declare myself a proud Democrat, but also a proud capitalist. And
how dare you?
I know, right? And it's not in vogue, I think, in some corners of my party these days, the word capitalism. But I did qualify it with the fact that we have a system that we have to make changes and fix. And Fox News and the conservative media picked it up and ran it over and over, like, look at this Democratic unicorn. She believes in capitalism. And I mean, and we all know that that's not true. There are a lot of Democrats who believe in capitalism and feel the way that I, you know, how I express myself. And so I sought to write a op-ed kind of explaining what I meant by that, the changes I thought needed to still be made to our overall system, why I'm a proud capitalist, given my history, knowing what the alternative looks like, having escaped communist Vietnam. And it was an op-ed that took me almost an entire month to get a mainstream media organization to carry. And they said no before they said yes. Fox News, Fox and Friends wanted me on, like constantly calling us. The conservative media wanted to have what they were painting as an outlier on to continue to stoke this narrative that was politically advantageous for conservatives to say that all of Democrats don't believe in capitalism. And but meanwhile, nobody in MSNBC, you know, none of those folks wanted to talk about this. Mm-hmm. And so not only do we have polarized media, we have media that aren't helping the party that they're theoretically aligned with. You know, and so it took a month before the Post finally ran the op-ed. But it shouldn't have been that hard, because I can point to other people who, they can write whatever they want, and it'll land in the op-ed pages of those yep. papers. And I think the media has to take a greater responsibility for what comes of their editorial decisions, what they choose to cover and what they choose to allow to run on their op-ed pages. Obviously, the Well, you guys are trying to provide that platform for the center, but we need other media to be willing to provide both sides of it, fair and balanced. Balance implies that you get, we have the predominant perspective, but you get somebody who represents a smaller part of that perspective to also provide their opinion, and now it looks like it's an even match, as opposed to, you know, reflecting what is true, which is that if it's an outlier position, you don't put them on with the people who represent the broad majority of the opinion. Yeah. And that's just not the way that the media works these days.
Yeah.